Hello once again, everyone. Now, this is a bit of a different video. Most people know that I'm a WWE fan, especially a CM Punk fan, and it's very rare that I'll do a video covering WWE news or something along those lines. I did a rant video on Undertaker's streak losing, or being broken, I should say, and so now we're going to talk about this. This came up just a few hours ago. CM Punk opens up on his WWE exit. So, first of all, let me just say, if you're one of those idiots who, you know, oh, WWE's fake, blah, 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 fuck off, this is not a video for you. This is CM Punk, Phil Brooks, his name, talking about his leaving of the company. Anyway, in an interview with Colt Cabana on Colt's podcast, The Art of Wrestling, CM Punk has opened up about his perceived decision to leave WWE. According to Punk, it all comes down to his mental health after repeated disappointment. He was miserable, and with enough of a bank balance to no longer need to wrestle, Punk put himself and his well-being first. Good on you, Punk. Money is not everything, ladies and gentlemen, Punk says. That will be a big theme in my story. How many times have I said that? Especially, like, in my gaming videos where I talk about how publishers and EA and Ubisoft and all these people just care about fucking money. Money is not everything. So good on you, Punk. Good on you, Punk. Anyway, let's continue here. Punk fears that by doing this interview and laying it all out on the table, there's a chance he'll be seen as bitter. Oh, boo-hoo. People were whining and bitching, calling Punk a, you know, a quitter and all that other stuff before. It's okay to be bitter about stuff. You have to eventually work through it and get over it, which is what I've done. But there are a few bright spots, a few things that still get me to this day. I'm the fucking happiest I've been in I don't know how long, at least 3 years, legitimately. I find these other things that have made me happy, and I thought these things that I loved, but just made me so miserable, all the time. It made me miserable. I guess the black and white of it is, when you boil it all down, the essence of it was I was miserable. I was unhappy, so fuck it. I made myself happy. I left. That's what it boils down to. It wasn't an easy decision to make, but it was also a long time coming. Again, who does this remind you of? Like when I quit the Miiverse, even though it's no such, like, it's not even anything remotely close to quitting the WWE, where I was just like, fuck it, I'm out. Anyway, one of the popular internet theories about Punk's leaving was that he wasn't happy with his creative direction and that he refused to work with Triple H. There's an element of truth in all of those things, but I can't say there was a big one thing that led to my decision, he says, before reiterating the biggest reason for leaving being his health. Regarding facing Triple H at WrestleMania, Punk says he didn't want to give him the fucking privilege, meaning he knows he considers himself much better than Triple H, which he is. Punk is convinced Triple H never liked him, the way he would always look sideways at me, the way he always treated me. Triple H thinks I'm a piece of shit. An example Punk offers revolves around a sponsorship deal. Punk was offered a huge sponsorship deal after the pipe bomb moment. Some of you may know what that was. He then pitched the idea to Vince McMahon, which would see Punk wearing UFC-styled fight shorts, which I don't really care if he did that or not. McMahon nixed the idea, as it could potentially cause problems. Lower guys on the card could get the same deals, thus leading to jealousy. McMahon told Punk it wasn't Punk's hill to die on. Then brought in Brock Lesnar, who does wear UFC fight shorts with sponsors on it. So that was like telling Punk, "Too bad, so sad. Thanks for the idea. You can't do it, but we're gonna bring in this guy who can." Like, that's fucking just insulting to CM Punk. Or Phil Brooks, I should say. Another example Punk cites of WWE saying one thing, doing another. Or wait, what? Saying one thing, then doing another, is when Punk went to walk out alongside his friend and fighter, Chael Sonnen at UFC. I don't know who that is. I don't watch UFC. When Punk told McMahon, the chairman's response was UFC was barbaric and that someone might die. I mean, whatever. Vince can think what he wants. Shortly after Punk's request, Triple H walked boxer Floyd Mayweather to the ring. So, again, there's their I can't fucking speak. Being a hypocrite there, again. Of the WWE environment, Punk says it's creatively stifling, toxic environment. Punk goes on to mention how he only received a fraction of what he earns the WWE. So, as a rough estimate, he says, hypothetically, he's worth $8 million. He'd only see around $500,000. That place should be the happiest place to work. And they use that as some bizarre mindfuck, you know? Go out there and have fun. It's like, fuck you, this place sucks, and on top of that, you're not fucking paying me nearly enough to do this shit. further issues with Punk not receiving his due dividend arose when WWE launched the WWE Network. Punk mentions WrestleMania before the network fans had to pay full price, but with WWE Network, they are in effect only paying $10 a month for it. Can the WWE still pay talent what they owed if the biggest pay-per-view of the year only cost $10? WWE doesn't do anything to protect the wrestlers, only to protect themselves. I got a concussion in the Royal Rumble. It's pretty goddamn obvious. I knew I had a concussion. Everyone knew I had. And they wanted me to take this test. And I was like, your test is bullshit. I took the test while texting Colt Cabana and listening to my headphones, and I passed. But then they were like, we want you to go to the ring and run the ropes. But I just passed their test. Yeah, but we still think you have a concussion. So your test is worthless. I'm not going out in the ring like a two-week rookie. That's, let's just call it now. Then he goes on about saying, speaking about leaving, Punk says that he didn't. He was miserable, but he never quit. According to Punk, WWE were avoiding his calls, then 2 days before his wedding to AJ Lee, who's fucking sexy as hell, he gets a text from Triple H asking if he had time to talk. Punk responded saying he's got to plan his honeymoon and make final preparations for the wedding, and he'll contact Triple H the moment he's back. Furthermore, Punk says he was owed 2 months' worth of royalties, which when he mentioned it to Triple H, Triple H ignored him. The day of my wedding, I got a FedEx in the mail. It was my termination papers. I was fired. Take that, everyone who says I'm a quieter, he says, making a joke about Twitter users who can't spell the word quitter. Punk laughed. He needed time off and was miserable. With some leg work and a spare 15 minutes, he called a lawyer. I called a guy, a vicious, vicious lawyer. He's Jewish, from L.A. I said, here's the deal, here's who I am, here's my story. I'm going on my honeymoon, and I'll call you when I'm back. And he's like, great, let's get these motherfuckers. And we did. We lawyered up, and we got those motherfuckers. While Punk can't discuss the settlement, he says he's got everything he wanted. Then, there was all this shit about the video game, which is dumb to them to advertise me, Punk says, referencing WWE 2K15. 2K Sports tweeted at me saying, do we have your attention now? Which was from his pipe bomb, of course. Well, 2K Sports, do I have your fucking attention now? Thanks for the big fat check. So that's the whole most of the interview anyway. There's a bunch of comments, of course. And it looks like my gamepad's about to die here, so I gotta wrap this up. But my point is, CM Punk, once again, has the balls to say what no one else does. He's exposed the bad conditions of WWE. He's shown his true side of things. He's explained what happened. And I gotta say, it's gonna suck to see... to not see Punk around in WWE. Like, this basically solidifies that he's done with WWE. And it's a damn shame, because he truly was the best in the world that WWE had at the current time. I mean, I still think Shawn Michaels is the all-time greatest, but Punk was amazing. There's no doubt about it. So it's sad that we're never going to see him back wrestling again, but it is good that he's happy now after 3 years of being miserable. A person can only take so much shit before they snap, you know, and they need to think about being happy again. So, good on you, Punk. I still respect you. You're still the best in the world. Yeah. Not much more else to say, but WWE, you fucked yourself over. I mean, there's still going to be, even though Punk's never coming back, there's still going to be those CM Punk chants, especially every time AJ comes out or anytime there's a match no one gives a fuck about on Raw. But you didn't treat Punk right. And you screwed yourself over. And now Punk's working for Marvel, of all places, really. I know, we all know he was a comic book fan. Like, he always shouted out, it's clobbering time, when he came out to the ring. So he's working with Marvel on writing Thor comic books, which is interesting. But yeah, that's going to do it for this video. I'm Original Blood Ace. As always, this was not a video game related video, of course, but it's something people who know I would talk about. So, of course, we'll see you next time with whatever video I do next. Stay tuned for more!